Hello and welcome to online gallery opening right here at the Main Street Gallery. My name is Kathleen Light. I am the director of the Ketchikan Area Arts and Humanities Council, and we are so excited for this online opening of Brooke Ratzat's exhibit, Exhale, Click, Release, Meditations with Camera. So I'm going to turn this over to Brooke, and she's going to talk about her exhibit. And I just want to thank all of you for joining us. This isn't exactly how Brooke had planned to have this gallery opening, but we're so thankful for her flexibility and her bravery in making this happen. So here we go. We're turning around to Brooke.
All right. Hi. Thank you. It's just Kathleen and I here in the gallery. We're 6 feet away from one another, but I'm just so pleased that you have all come to be part of this with me today. It has absolutely changed from its inception to what's hanging behind me right now in 1,000 wonderful ways, and my ability to connect with all of you all over the place is another piece of that. So this exhibit's all about meditation, and it's all about finding our calm. So I want to just jump right in and start this with the meditation. So I'm gonna ask you to do whatever it is that feels right to you to get into that place. For me, that's some breath work, and you can go ahead and take a look at the movements and follow along, or sip your wine, light a candle, do the things that make you feel in that place. And then Kathleen and I will walk around this exhibit and show you a little bit of what we have here. And then once we're done, we can talk a little bit more about it and what else we have to offer for you guys today. So this is a little bit of Tai Chi, Qigong. That's my method, as well as this walking meditation that I'll take you on today. So go ahead and take some deep breaths and follow along if you'd like. Really, this is just about gathering everything that's good and bringing it inside. Some more for good measure. Trails that I'll bring you on today. Each was photographed in the summer, fall, and winter. So my plan here is to tell you where we're at and then go ahead and give you a little quote, some guiding words before we start out. So this first one is the Rainbird Trail, shot August 1st from the Tao. 14. Look, and it can't be seen. Listen, and it can't be heard. Reach, and it can't be grasped. Image without an image. Subtle beyond all conception. Approach it, and there is no beginning. Follow it, and there is no end. You can't know it, but you can be it, at ease in your own life, Just realize where you come from. This is the essence of wisdom. Word Lake, October night. Bruce Lee. Empty your mind. Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. Now you put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put water into a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow or water can crash. Be water, my friend. Whitman Lake, January 7th, also from the Tao, 23. Express yourself completely, then keep quiet. Be like the forces of nature. When it blows, there is only wind. When it rains, there is only rain. When the clouds pass through, the sun shines through. Thank you for joining me. So we'll just go ahead and close out the meditation, and then we'll talk a little bit more. So this is just something I love to do when it's time for me to release. And so we got to start this with an exhale with our breath. We went through all the clicking, and now we get the release. So it's just a lift, a slow lift, and a quick release. If you have questions and you want to pop them up for Kathleen, otherwise I'm happy to answer questions. First, I'll tell you a little bit about our plans here. So Jason Baldwin made us a beautiful professional video of what you've seen here today, and that will be available for you to view as soon as we're done talking here. And it will also remain on the Arts Council's website. In that video, we have the beautiful sounds that were recorded by Kyle Bailey, Kyle G. Bailey. And so please check that out if you're interested. Thank you in purchasing any of these pieces. Katie and the crew here at the Arts Council has worked really hard to make sure that those are available for you, so you can absolutely purchase those prints on the website as well. Let's see, is that, Kathleen, is that the nuts and bolts of checking things off the list? So yeah, this is such an interesting experience where we expected this community event, and it's very made for the community, but then we have this opposing thing where we couldn't have you in here with us, but we get to have you out there with us. And so I'm so pleased and overwhelmed that the Arts Council and all of those helpers around made this solo exhibit a huge community and worldwide event. So thank you.
Yeah. So Brooke, tell us a little bit about your exhibit and why you hung it the way that you did.
Yeah, so everything about this exhibit from the very beginnings until now has changed and changed and changed. I wanted to make sure that I took you on this walk. So it was important to me to get the images off of the gallery walls, to create something that you're forced to meander through in the forest. And so my husband, Charlie, who's an awesome builder, we were talking about all these things that we could build, and we could, you know, do it with wood and nails or metal, and how can we create that? And that all just felt like too solid for this sort of ethereal idea that I wanted. And so we talked about hanging it from these strings, and so we did that, and then we got the strings, and then we're like, we need to anchor those strings to the ground somehow. And so I went ahead and I revisited all of these places and collected rocks from those places. So the rainbird prints are anchored with rocks from Rainbird, Ward Lake, and Whitman. And they all have a very different feel and texture and color. So that was a really fun way to bring the actual nature into this grounding idea. And then, when I started hanging all of this, it became a whole nother beast that I didn't expect. It became very boaty. I was tying bowlines, and from up there, I felt like I was on a 100-shipped mast hanging all of these. And then I finished, and the most delightful thing happened. These prints, whenever there's any kind of movement or energy in this space, they all breathe. They move on their own. And we leave for a day and we come back and everything needs to be just slightly adjusted because they all have a life of their own.
And so didn't you test this when you were putting this up, how they moved? Tell them that part.
Oh, yeah. So I spent a good half an hour running and sliding through the Warlick exhibit. Run, 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 slide. As all you dancers know, this is a great floor here. So, yeah, I had the opportunity to make these blow in the wind.
Great. Well, it looks like there aren't any questions from your adoring audience. What we saw mostly go by is this is exactly what people needed right now, and beautiful work, Brooke, and calming and stunning photography. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, just a reminder, you can see more of her work up close on the website, ketchikanarts.org. The video will be up there as well, but immediately following our Facebook Live, we will put up Jason Baldwin's video. So thank you all so much, and thank you, Brooke, and we will say goodbye.
Thank you.